Good morning and welcome from Spain. The drivers will be needing every bit of grip and confidence they can find today as they try to find their way around this historic circuit in some very difficult conditions. So it's dark skies overhead then and plenty of dark looks from the pit wall as well. A frustrating time for the engineers, Anthony Davidson, who I imagine were hoping for some dry running today. But it's absolutely chucking it down out there.
Oh, well, you have to feel for the guys and girls on the pit wall, Crofty. You know, so much work goes into getting these two cars out on track, not just from the pit wall, but from hundreds of people back at the factory too. The race team here at the circuit are just the most visible part of a very wide operation. And then the rain comes, and you immediately know a bunch of things. First, you aren't going to get much running. Second, you're going to see a lot of useless data, even if you do get out there. And third, the odds of needing an emergency rebuild before qualifying just went through the roof.
I've had a chat with Carl about the new parts, and we're happy that they've been integrated into the car okay. With any luck, you'll be able to feel the improvement, so give them a try. That's fantastic. You obviously have a really good understanding of this circuit. Program complete and a job well done. We got some excellent data with our run, so come on back to the garage and I can talk you through the numbers. Test complete, and that was a very good job indeed. We got a lot of valuable information out of that. Good job indeed. We got a lot of valuable information out of that.
Join us today at the Circuit de Barcelona-Catalunya for what's bound to be a really hectic qualifying as the teams compete to set the best lap times. And as we wait, poised for the start of what will hopefully be a thrilling qualifying, why don't you tell us, Anthony Davidson, about the things you can do to really get the most out of a car in a session like this?
Well, you're largely limited by the Parc Fermé regulations, of course. Back in the old days, pre-2004, you'd work on both a qualifying setup and a race setup over practice, and then swap them over after qualifying. So the race car was quite different at times to the qualifying car. Nowadays, though, you have to find a compromise that works for both. There are a few things that you can still adjust during the session, such as the differential, the brake bias, and the front wing angle, but that's about it. So it's more about optimizing what you do have and adapting your own style to suit the track conditions.
So as for the cars around us, just ahead are Sainz, Hülkenberg and Stroll. And behind us are Ricciardo, Weber and Vettel. Currently the fastest lap is a 1:19.7.
I think we can call that a successful qualifying. We should be in with a good chance in the race.
What does the Spanish Grand Prix have in store for us today, I wonder? I hope we see some tight wheel-to-wheel action down the main straight, circa Mansell and Senna way back in 91, or maybe we'll have a more strategic race here on a track where overtaking can be difficult. The Circuit de Barcelona-Catalunya, then. A high-speed 2.89-mile circuit which demands an efficient downforce package and bravery on the part of the driver, especially through the blind right of Turn 9, which we might just see taken flat this weekend. Anthony Davison is here with me today. Together, we'll be taking you through all the action at the Spanish Grand Prix. It can be hard for the cars to follow each other closely here due to all the dirty air coming off the car in front. So perhaps we're looking at a more strategic Grand Prix. What do you think on that one, Ant?
I'm not too sure about that, Crofty. Yes, it's hard to follow, but if you're brave on the brakes and willing to commit, there are definitely opportunities to be had here, like down into Turn 10 after the DRS zone, for example. I don't think this is a race that's going to be decided purely in the pit stops.
It's time to see how our drivers are stacking up after yesterday's exciting qualifying session. Lewis Hamilton lines up on pole position and Valtteri Bottas will line up alongside. Moving on to the rest of the grid, we have Verstappen, Vettel, Romain Grosjean and Sainz, Norris, Magnussen, Perez and Lance Stroll, Butler, Gasly, James and Raikkonen, Leclerc. They've taken a grid penalty. Ricciardo, Alexander Albon and Lucas Faber, Russell and Nico Hülkenberg completes the grid. And now it's time to head down to the track.
Seeing any technical issues coming off the practice start. Watch the RPM on a full start. We don't want to bog down. The rest of the grid is forming up. Be patient and watch for the lights. is dropping back by about 3/10 a lap. Is ahead of you. The gap to the car ahead is 4.8 seconds. They're on old mediums. Their tyres are 14 laps old. We think they've got one more stop. The time last lap was a 1 minute 23.8. You're dropping back by around 2/10 each lap. Kimi is in for his stop. Exit now. That was our last stop. No more scheduled pit stops. Managing your tyres. Manage your tyres. mistake, we could still regain the position.
I love your sense of humor.
Judging you guys. Good day today. Let's have your take on it.
You've had experience with Devon's fast, aggressive style. Any advice for the drivers he passed today? You and Devon weren't far apart by the end of the race. How evenly matched are you? Did you struggle to get through all that traffic today? You're surpassing all expectations. Can anything or anyone stop you?
Great. Well, that's everything.
Looks like one of your rivals is also going to an upcoming historical event. If you choose to take him on, it might help get your name out there a bit.
Spin, you bounce, swim, push, crash, park, walk, hurt, you blink, you fight, you fly, you win, you laugh, you cry, you breathe, you breathe, you breathe, you've done it. Monaco, where legends are made.